Alright. Instead of running 686 miles, I'll just use my little magic spell. Boop. Yo, Graham. Got some good news.
You all got different Saltuna here on Monarch. Ain't that neat?
You come to Monarch and that's what you're excited about. You ought to get out more.
I'm getting out right now.
Huh. She's got a point. She is out right now. Hi.
Hey.
Hi.
If you'll just listen.
No. No more listening.
I'm here again.
Preaching. We are losing people left and right.
Hello.
We need to act.
Hello, people.
Enough, Zora. I'm not putting the torch to innocent people.
I am.
Do you want to bring the board's cruisers and gunships down on us? Captain, apologies, but our situation grows dire. Our people talk of foolish endeavors. What news do you bring?
First of all, I think you two should just get married and get it over with. What are you guys arguing about?
We're out of time. We need food and ammunition. We need to hit Stellar Bay while we still have the manpower to do it.
You want to attack the city?
Yes. I know it's drastic, but it's clear that Sanjar will never cooperate. And if it's him or us, I choose us.
Are they really doing better than you are?
Doubtful. But we don't need much, and Sanjar isn't going to share.
Well, sure, but that seems a bit desperate.
It is. We are desperate. We're starving. My people are dying left and right.
Well, I know you can't eat this, but I've been to the printing press. It's clear.
Excellent.
Did you find the Van Noys?
Yes, the Van Noys are on their way back.
Thank the Eternal.
We're one step closer to bringing the truth to every man, woman, and child in Halcyon.
Friendly.
This plan's brilliance is in its subtlety. For the time being, let us cease our activities on the tower, lest we bring premature attention upon us.
Tower?
I have much to do. Articles to write, sermons to ponder. We live in such an exciting time. Let's talk later.
Hey, I need to see to the wounded, but drop by the clinic when you can. I want a word.
Revering? Oh, god damn it.
Nioka, I can smell you're having fun.
Gonna need to buy myself an entire Rizzo plant after all this.
Surely now you'll let me steal some mag picks. Okay, we're gonna go to the clinic. Get in here so you'll actually talk to me.
Hey, Captain. I need your help, and we ought to keep it hush-hush.
Alright, close the door.
You know about what happened here, right? The history of Amber Heights?
Fella came through Edgewater once, mentioned something to my dad about pirates wiping out of town. You mean this is the same place?
Oh, I didn't know that.
Right. Common belief is that the pirates fled to an old relay station that had already been abandoned, but nobody could find them. The station's locked up, but one of my people found an old data cartridge in a nearby rat nest. It's mostly corrupted, but I pulled a couple codes off of it. One is the code to the Amber Heights gate. I don't recognize the other, but it's similar. I bet it opens a door.
The Amber Heights gate?
Right. The access codes to Amber Heights. What gets me is, if this belonged to the pirates, that means they knew someone there. If someone gave them the gate code, all those deaths, Captain. All that blood is on their hands.
Why are we keeping this to ourselves?
Graham isn't fond of talking about the history here. He had friends who worked here. The massacre hit him pretty hard. You know him. Live and let live and all that. I don't want to burden him right now. Especially if this ends up being a dead end.
A dead end, yeah. A random door code doesn't sound like that useful.
I know it's a long shot, but if we miss something there, if you can get into that station, maybe we can get some answers.
I don't get what's so important about this. Don't you have bigger problems right now? Like feeding yourselves and stuff?
I surely do. But it's not far. And if they died in there, they died with their munitions. We'll need them. Besides, if it's filled with valuables from the aristocrats who lived here, we can pawn them off on Sublight and get ourselves ahead on our food budget.
Okay. So I'll go to the relay station, see if the code is useful, and anything else?
Just a warning. The area is infested with mantisaurs. I'd send some help, but we're, you know, preparing for war.
Alright, I'm on it.
Appreciate it. Here's the code. If it works, bring back anything you find. Supplies are best, but information's good too.
Right.
If someone was behind the Amber Heights massacre, I'd give a lot of people around here some closure to find out who and string them up. Good luck. Watch out for the taros. Welcome back. You find anything out there?
Not yet. I've walked about 4 steps. So what'd you give us? Relay station access code. Zora shared with you access codes one of her people... That one of her people had found in the wilderness. Okay, we got some typos here. Not typos, grammatical errors. Given their proximity to an old relay station, it's a safe bet they opened the station's door. Then again, just as easily be the code to someone's secret stash of Andy Cleo-inspired adult magazines. Only one way to find out. Well, that would be interesting as well. Journal... Sucker Beat. Zora's asked to investigate an old relay station has been overrun by monsters. She hopes to find answers to the mystery of the Amber Heights massacre. She thinks the code you give her to the relay station's entrance. Right, which is there. Okay. And that's a little further, right? Is that the same space? These here? No, that's here, and the other thing is here. Okay. Maybe I should return first before all hell breaks loose. Check in with these guys. See if I can get any more ammo. Right here, oh. That guy's holding up.
Captain.
Oh, Captain, you did it! My little boy is back, safe and sound! Tell the Captain how grateful we are, Tuck-Tuck.
Oh, brother.
Mama, I told you that I'm not staying.
Tuck-Tuck?
I just came back to talk to you about why I left. Then I'm going back to Amber Heights.
Oh, we'll get that silliness sorted out. You're safe here with me, and that's how it's going to stay. Isn't that right?
Before I start arguing with you, do you mention a reward for bringing Tucker home?
I did, didn't I? Suppose I can't expect you to just be content at a good deed done?
Absolutely not.
No?
Nope.
Well, all right.
Thank you.
Here, kind stranger. This is every bit I've scrimped and scraped for years to save.
But it's more than worth it to have my Tuk-Tuk home safe again.
Good luck to you both. Especially you. Tuk-Tuk.
Don't worry about me, Captain. Mama and I'll work this out.
Just do me a favor and try not to strangle her.
My boy says he'll only stay a few days before returning to Amber Heights. Can't you speak to him for me?
I'll try.
Don't drag other people into this, Mama. I'm a grown man and an iconoclast. It's time for me to make my own path in life.
Yes, ma'am.
I just don't know why you want to leave, Tuk-Tuk. You know how dangerous it is out there with the Raptodons and the Mantisaurs.
Enough, Mama. I made my decision. I won't let fear run my life any longer. Thank you, Captain. I got it from here.
Good luck. Don't kill her. If it was me, I probably would.
So the ship talks? Do all ships do that?
I can't say for certain.
Don't think so.
I've only ever been on this one. Ada's something special, though, ain't she?
Ada, what is it? She? It? I'm a bit fuzzy on the details.
I thought she was a simulated intelligence. You know, a long series of commands telling her how to react to certain inputs.
You used to. What do you think now?
Well, I worked with a lot of machines, and ain't none of them like her. They can be pretty smart, but mostly they're rule books with a voice box. Ada's different.
One of life's mysteries, I suppose. I don't trust it. If it crashes us into a star, I'll be a mite upset.
If we crash into a star, we're not going to be anything other than cinders, or not even that. Whatever comes after cinders as far as dying. I guess some gaseous vapor? We don't have the luxury of being upset. Let's see if we can get any... ammo. We can! Personality attributes. I think we'll hold on to the rest then. Yeah, we gained this as from completing one of those quests, but it's not that great. Made by Hephaestus and customized to protect an apostle. Oh yeah. Just not worth it. I'll break this one down. I don't need to go in the bathroom. Oops.
I wonder sometimes what they're doing on other colonies.
You do?
Uh-huh.
Think they're watching the same serials, following the same football game?
Mm-hmm. You're not listening to a word I say. Right, he's not. How much do I have? Keep forgetting to look. Yeah, I now have a pretty acceptable amount of heavy ammo. Not armor. she at it. Oh, the broker is outside, that's right. Some more machines over here somewhere. Yeah, there's one here. There's one up by the reliable. There's one out this way.
I hear those rich people in Byzantium pay a handsome bit for rat musk.
Bet they also pay to make it stink less.
Supposedly it makes you more attractive for, you know.
Trust me? No one's going near you.
Here we go. Full stock, hello. And then straight that way. This is where I just was. There's three over here, though. Oh, the yacht club. Sebastian, where? Zing is over there. So I guess there's one upstairs in the yacht club. I did this one. Yeah. That Zhang's there. It's telling me there's two. Yacht Club. Yacht Club. What's the same? Maybe there's one outside? And then Sebastian's got one. Pardon me.
So Ada isn't really alive, but it... Sorry, she can still talk like a person. What about Sam? What's it... Sorry. He? Is he the same thing?
Sam's an automechanical thing, not a computer brain thing like Ada. I don't think Sam understands gender, so you can call him it if you want.
Right, but she's a machine, he's a machine. How are they different?
You know how I said Ada was special? Her wiring's a whole lot more complex than Sam's, so she can simulate a personality better than he can. She got more tools in her box, so to speak.
Tools
so
in her
box. He's following
box.
His own rules, making everything obnoxiously clean because he has to. Maybe I ought to let up on him a bit.
Zhang's Emporium. is where? Behind us somewhere. Who just leaves magpicks around like that? There's two here. Maybe that's what I was picking up. No? No, they're separate. That's different. Thank you. Is there one up here too?
So, guess who Celia brought home the other night?
Celia.
Finally. Now she can stop buying that junk from him. Might improve the smell. Yeah. The noise.
Oh, that's Celia. Yeah, the assistant. The sand jar. Should we check in with her then? Apparently now she brought him home. Right. Oh, I discovered this. Have I never been in here?
You seen Graham's new magazines? Certainly colorful.
Yeah.
Poor Isaac.
We don't get many outsiders.
You don't look like Sublight. Must be freelance.
Everett?
Good day to you.
Whoa, by the stars, my poor heart. I just about pissed my jumpsuit.
I miss this place, Chef Raymond. Why would you admit that to anyone?
Because there's no shame in having overactive bladder muscles, all right? It's a perfectly normal medical condition.
Huh.
Besides, life in this town is enough to try anyone's nerves.
Oh yeah, how's that?
Where should I begin? With the oversized mantisaurs? Or perhaps the rat spewing acid at our walls? The board was right. This place isn't fit for human habitation. And I was a fool for staying.
Why did you decide to stay in the first place?
Sanjar, of course. He had all these glorious ideas about how he'd run Monarch. Rest periods between every work shift. No shift more than 10 hours long.
You company folk are all the same. Choose to stay, then complain about the choice you've made.
How was I supposed to know it'd turn out like this?
Hmm.
It all sounds wonderful. Until you realize there's only a few centimeters of repurposed steel between you and the deadliest creatures in the galaxy.
Seems like you'd want more than centimeters.
I could do with a few kilometers of cold vacuum, but that spaceship is flown.
Ever thought about leaving Stellar Bay?
Only every day. But in case you haven't noticed, we don't exactly get ships on a regular basis, yours notwithstanding. And even if I did scrape together enough to buy passage out with Sublight, which would mean reaching Fallbrook without getting eaten, shot, or dissolved into green goop, what then?
You forgot stabbed. That's also a possibility.
Well, thank you for reminding me. As if I weren't already destined for an early grave.
Huh.
Only every day. And even if I did scrape together enough to buy passage out with Sublight...
Why don't you just tell me?
Nothing, that's what. Because MSI is not in what you'd call good standing with the board. So even if I could get out of here, no one's gonna hire me.
That sounds rough. I wonder if we could use a cook.
Even talking about it has my blood pressure up. I've really gotta stop. Lucky you.
Thank you. I would hire him on as a cook. Totally would. Ooh, what we got here? Fishies. I had no idea about any of this stuff, and yeah. I hate when I do that. And I'm wasting stuff. Look at that. I have five more. Well, I have six. And six. I have plenty of Adrenos, but... And it won't let me... rebind for some reason. It's like not working right now. Well, that's not what I'm trying to change, but still. Wait. Unbind key. Rebind. Oh. There we go. So now when I press this button, nothing happens. Good. So maybe I'll stop doing that then. Moap, moap.
Nice.
Nice. Doing bits cobbled exo suit. Cool. Sweet. So, you guys have a... sell this, some of the stuff I found right here. Place is this? Unknown. So I just went in there. There's one, well, that's a workbench. And yeah, ahead of me is three. Sebastian's is supposed to have one. Sebastian's waffle emporium?
What did Stellar Bay's engineer name your cannon machine?
I don't rightly know. That'd have been Guster, I think? I'd ask him, but he fell in the machine once, so. Could call it Guster's Demise or the Guster Crusher? Oh, that's got a ring to it.
So.
Forget I asked.
Okay, he sells stuff.
You look like a woman who's looking for some mostly fresh animal parts.
Sebastian, you ever get your hands on those pheromone sacks? Manipillars ain't gonna hunt themselves, you know.
I must have hunted a dozen, but I couldn't find a single sack on any of them. Must be looking in the wrong place.
Hmm.
Manipillars ain't got pheromone sacks. I just told him that so he'd stop asking me for advice.
At least I'm getting a good haul of claws in the process. You're in good hands, traveling with Monarch's top merc. Still, if you want any rat glands or manticlaws, I've got you covered.
So he doesn't sell ammo. So he's a vendor is what it is, but he's not a vending machine. Makes sense? That's what got me confused. Looking for the vending machine near him. So then the other one is back there, which I already did. So I think I've got all of them except for the one by the ship. So maybe the other yacht club thing is somebody, a person who sells that stuff. Well, there's this. Oh, that's that. Okay, there's not one up by the ship. There's one in here, which I think that's the MSI board. And then we're done. I just want to get all the ammo I possibly can. This one? No, it's not that, but I'll... Yeah, I don't think I hit this one. Then again, I probably did. Did you... You had a date with what's-his-name?
Carry on.
I want her to tell me about it. Okay, so that one... I got. There's one ahead and to the right. Probably in here. Here, right? This one? Yeah. I think I might have hit this one. Yep, I did. Okay. Okay, so I now have a journal, a codex thing. Oh, I took that by mistake. Boop. .1407 heavy ammo. Amber Heights Crossroads, and then I'll head from there. Yep. This So I'll be heading over here to take care of this. Oh no, not that yet. Old relay station has been overrun by monsters. She hopes to find answers to the mystery of the Amber Heights massacre. She thinks the code she gave you to the relay station's entrance. I don't like the way it's called. Sucker bait? Does not inspire me with confidence, but we're going to be heading over that way. We'll stick to the road because it goes right up to it. I'm sure we're getting tons of trouble on the way there as well. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.